Good morning to everyone. This is the sum in front of your screen, which we will be doing now. Let us read the sum. Mr. Arvind entered into following transactions of purchase and sale of equity shares of ASPI Limited. So Mr. Arvind, he's an investor who have entered into following transactions of purchase and sale of equity shares of ASPI Limited. ASPI Limited is the name of the company where the investment is done on per equity shares. The shares have paid up value of rupees 10 per share. So paid up value, face value is 10 rupees. Nominal value is 10 rupees. On 1-1-2012, Mr. Arvind has bought 600 shares at rupees 20. On 15th March, 900 shares on rupees 25. On 25, that is 20 May, 1,000 shares at 22 rupees. On 25th July, 2012, bonus shares was received. Bonus shares are given free of cost. So we'll have to pass the effect of bonus share, 2,500 shares. Then on 20 December 2012, there is a sale at 22. And whenever there is a sale, we will have to calculate profit or loss. So whenever there is a sale, we will have to calculate profit or loss made on sale. And on 1 February 2013, there is one more sale. What they have given in additional information, on 15th September 2012, dividend of rupees 3 per share was received for the year 31st March 2012. So 15th September 2012, what did ASPI Limited do? It declared dividend 3 rupees per share. So kya milne wala hai? 3 rupees ka dividend milne wala hai. And this dividend is received for the year 31st March 2012. So this is very important. Dividend 3 rupees ka milega. And kaun si year end ke liye? Year end is 31st March 2012. On 12th November 2012, the company made a right issue. Now, right issue is given to the here. The preference of right issue means when the company is again coming with a fresh issue, the preference to purchase the share is given to the existing equity shareholders. So on 12th November 2012, the company made a right issue of equity share in the ratio of 1 share for 5 shares held. So for every 5 shares, 1 share will be given in payment of rupees 20 per share. So amount to be paid is 20 rupees per share for the right issue. And right shares are not given free of cost like the bonus shares. It involves a price, involves a cost. So it is 20 rupees per share. And Mr. Arvind subscribed to 60% of the share and renounced the remaining shares on receipt of premium of rupees 3 per share. So here we are concerned only on the shares which has been purchased by Mr. Arvind. Arvind Limited subscribed for 60% of the share. So we are concerned only of that 60% shares which Mr. Arvind has purchased, subscribed. We are not concerned on renounced shares. and they have told that we have to value the shares on weighted average cost basis, which we always do in every sum. So you are required to prepare investment account for the year ended 31st March 2012 and 31st March 2013. You will have to prepare for 2 years, 2 year ended 31st March 2012 and 31st March 2013. So we have prepared the table in the books of Mr. Arvind. Investment in equity shares of ASPI Limited. What is the first transaction? 1-1-2012 को परचेज किया है. परचेज करेंगे तो इट विल कम हियर 1-1-2012. परचेज करेंगे तो व्हाट विल हैपन? कैश बैंक, कैश बैंक. मनी विल गो आउट, मनी विल गो आउट. How many shares have we purchased? We have purchased 600 shares at 20 rupees. One share is of 10 rupees. So 600 into 10 is how much? 600 into 10 is 6,000. 600 into 10 is 6,000. And here in the cost column, we have purchased the share for 20 rupees. So 600 share into 20, we get 12,000 rupees. So first step, we have passed the entry for purchase. And purchase means there is no question of profit or loss. Either we have paid more or we have paid less. In any way, cash is going out. So pehla entry, pehla effect ho gaya. But now whenever we will purchase or sale or any or right share or bonus share, we have to give the effect. We have to record it in our cost structure. 600 share nominal value 6,000, cost is 12,000. Now we can go to the next transaction, which is on 15th March. Again it is a purchase. So on 15th March 2012, what has happened? 1 minute, let me increase this. 15th March 2012, again there is a purchase. Purchase for how many share? Purchase for 900 share at 25 rupees. So 900 into 10, because nominal value is 10, this become 9,000, and 900 into 25. So 900 into 25 is 22,500. So whenever we are doing a purchase, anything sale, it has to be recorded in the cost structure. So let us record the second purchase, 900 units. And this is 9,000 and this is 22,500. So how much unit we have? 9 + 6 = 1,500. 900 and 600 is 1,500. This will be 15,000 and this will be 34,500. This is 34,500. This is done. So now we have to close, because 15th March ke baad, next transaction what they have given is on 20 May. Or 20 May se pehle there comes year end. Year end hai 31st March 2012 ko. So 31st March 2012. 31st March 2012. 31st March 2012 ko, what has happened? Let us write the year 31st March. So 31st March ko, we will have to pass the entry for the balance. Because year end, we will have to close the books. So let us close it. Kitna we got? 15,000. Here we got 34,500. and same 15,000, 34,500. Balance will be the same because there is no sale, anything. The same amount will come, 34,500. But next year, your next date, 1/4/2012, there is buy balance becomes two balance brought down, and same amount 15,000, 34,500 will come down. So buy balance carried down in the next day, it becomes the opening balance, two balance brought down. So now let us see what entry is there. There is one more purchase on 20 May. How many unit? 1,000 unit at 22 rupees. So we will go to 20 May 2012. Because we are purchasing, our money goes out. 1,000 unit. So 1,001 unit of this 10 rupees, 1,000 into 10. But we are purchasing for 22 rupees. So 1,000 into 22 is 22,000. So we'll go to the cost structure. Again, there is a purchase. So here we will take this down. There is a purchase. There is a purchase. 1,000 unit. And nominal value is 10,000. And cost value is 22,000. We have purchased for 22 rupees. So what we will do, we will take the total 2,500, 25,000, and this becomes 56,500. So now let us go to the next entry. Because whenever there is a purchase, we need not think about profit or loss. Next on 25/7/2012, there is bonus share of 2,500. So bonus share is given for free. There will be no cost involved. What is the date of bonus share? It is 25/7/2012. So 25th July 2012, because money is not going out, this is bonus shares. We will write down the name bonus shares. 2,500 into 10, this becomes 25,000, and the cost for bonus share is nil. There is no cost involved. So our bonus shares, we have to give the effect of bonus shares. Bonus share 2,500, and this becomes 25,000, and this is zero, no cost. So here it becomes 5,000, here it becomes 50,000, and here it is the same 56,500. क्यों? कि बोनस शेयर फ्री में मिला है, तो बोनस शेयर का कोई कॉस्ट नहीं है. बोनस शेयर इज कैपिटलाइजेशन ऑफ रिजर्व, मींस देयर इज नो कॉस्ट इन्वॉल्वड. सो हियर व्हाट वी विल डू, बोनस शेयर आल्सो डन. सो द नेक्स्ट एंट्री व्हिच इज गिवन इज फॉर 20 December. But before 20 December, there is an entry on 15th September. Dividend is paid for the year ended 31st March 2012. So what is the entry? Dividend is paid on 15th. This is 2012. 15th September ke liye in dividend diya. So we'll have to go to the working note. So working note mein calculation of dividend. Now dividend is paid on 15th September. Dividend is paid on 15th September, and for the period, which period it is paid? for the period 31st March 2012. So ये dividend जो pay हुआ है company ने 31st March 2012 के लिए dividend pay किया है, तो उस time पे we had how many share? We had 1500 shares. हमारे पास 1500 shares थे. यहाँ पे देखो, we had 1500 shares और 25 को हमने और 1000 shares खरीदा on 31st March 2012. We had 15,000, मतलब हमारे पास इतना shares था. हमारे पास कितना था? 1500 shares था, जिसका nominal value 15,000 and cost 34,500. But हमें जो dividend मिला, we got the dividend on September 15. और September 15 को now company will not go to workout कि 31st मार्च में मिस्टर अरविंद के पास सिर्फ 1500 shares था, तो उसको सिर्फ 1500 shares के लिए dividend दो था. Company will not do that. Company will on 15th September check the register of members list, register of shareholders list, and वो date में जिस भी शेयरहोल्डर के नाम पे जितना भी शेयर्स रजिस्टर्ड है, डिविडेंड विल बी पेड टू देम अकॉर्डिंगली. मींस आपको, आप 31 मार्च को इवन आपके शेयर थे, पर 15 सितंबर तक आपने बेच दिया वो शेयर्स को, तो यू आर नॉट एलिजिबल फॉर एनी डिविडेंड. सो यू विल गेट डिविडेंड एज पर द नेम्स मेंशन इन द रजिस्टर ऑफ मेंबर्स. अगर आपका नाम इतने शेयर्स के लिए मेंशन है, भले 31st मार्च जब डिविडेंड डिक्लेयर किया गया, दैट टाइम यू डिड नॉट हैव सो मेनी शेयर्स, स्टिल यू विल गेट द शेयर डिविडेंड फॉर द शेयर्स मेंशनड इन योर नेम ऑन द पेमेंट ऑफ डिविडेंड डेट. सो योर डेट इज 15 सितंबर, दैट डे अरविंद के पास जितना भी शेयर्स होगा उसके लिए ही विल बी गेटिंग डिविडेंड. सो उस दिन उसके पास अभी 15 सितंबर में 5000 शेयर्स, but 5000 shares pay 2500 shares are bonus shares. Bonus shares exist ही नहीं करते थे on 31st March. Bonus shares have been given on 25th July. Bonus shares got created and paid on 25th July. But dividend is declared on 31st March 2012. That time these bonus shares were not in existence. Bonus shares उस दिन exist ही नहीं करते थे, तो उसके ऊपर तो कोई dividend नहीं मिलेगा. But bonus shares पे भी dividend मिल सकता है, but from next year onwards. Now they are not eligible for dividend, because now the dividend which is paid is for the previous year 2012. 31st March. Now the dividend which is being paid is for the last year, previous year, and in that period these bonus shares were not existing. The bonus share were not present. So इसके लिए इस पे तो dividend मिलेगा ही नहीं. तो कितना बचा? 2500 shares पे bonus share को निकाल के कितना बचता है? तो 5000 में 2500 का बोनस शेयर डिलीट कर दिया, माइनस कर दिया. सो वी आर लेफ्ट विद 2500 शेयर, आउट ऑफ विच 1500 शेयर्स वेर एग्जिस्टिंग विद अस. 1500 शेयर्स विद वेर विद अरविंद बिलोंग टू हिम ऑन 31st मार्च 2012, बट 1000 शेयर्स ही परचेज ऑन 20 मे. 20 मे को उसने 1000 शेयर्स एडिशनल परचेज किया. अब उसको डिविडेंड पूरा 2500 शेयर्स पे मिलेगा, बिकॉज कंपनी विल नॉट गो ऑन सर्चिंग दैट ऑन 31st मार्च यू हैव सो मेनी शेयर्स, सो गिव यू डिविडेंड ऑन ओनली दैट मेनी शेयर्स. इट विल गिव डायरेक्टली ऑन द पेमेंट डेट, डिविडेंड पेमेंट डेट. जितना भी शेयर्स आपके नाम पे रहेगा, सारे शेयर्स पे यू विल बी गेटिंग द डिविडेंड, एक्सेप्ट बोनस शेयर्स पे नहीं मिलेगा. बिकॉज जिस दिन डिविडेंड डिक्लेयर किया गया 31st मार्च 2012, उस दिन दीज शेयर्स वे नॉट इन एग्जिस्टेंस. See, on 15 September 2012, dividend of rupees 3 per share was received for the year ended 31 मार्च 2012 से 31 मार्च 2012 के लिए डिविडेंड मिलने वाला है। तो ऑन 31 मार्च 2012 कितना शेयर था? मिस्टर अरविंद हैज 1500 शेयर्स। मिस्टर अरविंद हैज 1500 इक्विटी शेयर, ये रो 600 प्लस 900 इक्विटी शेयर। सो डिविडेंड कितना रहेगा? डिविडेंड इक्वल टू 1500। एवरी शेयर पे 3 रुपीज का डिविडेंड मिलने वाला है। एवरी शेयर पे 3 रुपीज का डिविडेंड मिलने वाला है। सो 1500 इंटू 3 वी आर गेटिंग 4500 एज डिविडेंड ऑन 1500 शेयर्स। सो 1500 इंटू 3 वी आर गेटिंग 4500 एज डिविडेंड। सो रिमेनिंग शेयर्स इज 2500 टोटल शेयर है, उसमें 1500 माइनस किया तो 1000 शेयर्स विच वेर परचेज ऑन, दीज शेयर्स वेर परचेज ऑन हाउ वे विच डेट 20 मई 2012। सो उस पे डिविडेंड कितना है? उस पे डिविडेंड जो मिस्टर अरविंद को मिलेगा विल बी 1000 इनटू एवरी शेयर 3 रुपीज डिविडेंड, दिस विल बी 3000। सो यहाँ पे एस आई हैव टोल्ड यू कि जो 31 मार्च में जो शेयर्स था उसके ऊपर जो डिविडेंड मिला वो एक्चुअल डिविडेंड है। सो यहाँ पे डिविडेंड का रहेगा बाई, बिकॉज मनी वी विल गेट, डिविडेंड का पैसा मिल रहा है, हाउ मच 4500। दिस इज 4500 वर्किंग नोट नंबर 2। एंड जो हमें द डिविडेंड व्हाट वी हैव गॉट आफ्टर 31 मार्च के बाद जो हमने शेयर्स खरीदा इस पे तो हमें डिविडेंड नहीं मिलना चाहिए, बिकॉज 31 मार्च को मैंने डिविडेंड डिक्लेयर किया गया हमारे पास ये शेयर्स नहीं था, ये 1000 शेयर्स दिस वी परचेस लेटर ऑन, बट कंपनी आपके हाथ में जितना शेयर्स है ऑन 15th September यू विल बी गेटिंग डिविडेंड फॉर ऑल ऑफ देम। तो इसको हम मानते हैं दिस इज प्री एक्विजिशन डिविडेंड। इसको क्या करेंगे? लेस प्री एक्विजिशन डिविडेंड। प्री एक्विजिशन मीन्स हमें ये जो डिविडेंड मिला है ये हमने शेयर्स एक्वायर ही नहीं किया था ऑन 31 मार्च, ये परचेस ही नहीं था, तो हम क्या करेंगे ये प्री एक्विजिशन डिविडेंड को हम मानेंगे कि ये डिविडेंड मिलने से जो मैंने 22,000 पे किया था ये शेयर के लिए, आई हैव पे 22,000 फॉर 1000 शेयर्स, अब 3000 मुझे वापस मिल गया तो मेरा कॉस्ट 22,000 माइनस 3000 सिर्फ 19,000 हुआ। मीन्स हमें जो ये नॉर्मल डिविडेंड दिस इज फॉर द शेयर्स विच वी हैव विच बिलोंग टू अस, 1500 शेयर जो 31 मार्च को हमारे ही पास था उसके ऊपर मिलने वाला डिविडेंड डिविडेंड कॉलम में लिखा, जो हमने हमारे पास शेयर्स नहीं था 1000 शेयर्स विच वी परचेस लेटर ऑन दैट विल कम इन द कॉस्ट कॉलम। उसको हम कहां लिखेंगे? ये डिविडेंड को हम कॉस्ट कॉलम में लिखेंगे। दिस इज द स्टेप, डिविडेंड इज डन। नाउ वी ऑल्सो हैव राइट शेयर्स, वी ऑल्सो हैव राइट शेयर्स। सो राइट शेयर्स का रेशियो इज 1 share for 5 shares held। तो पहले लेट अस राइट हियर 5000, 50,000 एंड माइनस 3000, 53,500। So here let us go to the right share calculation of right share. The ratio kya hai? One right share for five shares held, or five equal right share is also an equity share, but here we are getting right share for five shares held, getting one equity share, which is when companies right share means when companies again after the initial offer, when again coming with the fresh issue, the first preference to purchase these shares are given to the existing equity shareholder. So one right share for five equity shares held. So how many shares are held by us? We are having 5,000 shares. So yahan pe we will write 5,000. Here, I will again explain this calculation of right shares. One right share for every five shares held. So we are having 5,000 equity shares. 5,000 equity shares we are having. So we do a cross multiplication. If अगर एक राइट शेयर के लिए एक राइट शेयर मिलेगा 5,000, अगर हमारे पास 5 इक्विटी शेयर है तो एक राइट शेयर मिलेगा, तो हमारे पास तो टोटल रेशियो इज 1 राइट शेयर फॉर एवरी 5 शेयर्स हेल्ड. सो वी हैव टोटल, मिस्टर अरविंद हैज टोटल 5,000 right shares, na? Sorry, Mr. Arvind has 5,000 equity shares. So cross multiply karo, usko kitna right shares milna chahiye? 5,000 into 1 divide by 5 means usko 1,000 right shares milna chahiye. Kitna right share milna chahiye? 1,000 right shares milna chahiye. Ab ye 1,000 right share मिलना चाहिए 20 rupees के हिसाब से. How do I know 20 rupees? Here they have given that held on the company मेरा right issue of equity shares in the ratio of one share for every five shares held on payment of 20 rupees. So right share हमें 20 rupees में मिलेगा. But Mr. Arvind, उसने subscribe कितना shares किया? उसने सब्सक्राइब सिर्फ 60% ऑफ द राइट शेयर्स को किया, तो यहाँ और बाकी 40% उसने सेल कर दिया. सो हियर ये इतना राइट शेयर मिलेगा 1,000, बट मिस्टर अरविंद सब्सक्राइब्ड फॉर 60% शेयर्स. सो वो कितना हो जाएगा? 1,000 इंटू 60%, which is equal to 600 right shares. Mr. Arvind was eligible to get 1,000 right shares, but he subscribed for only 660% right shares of rupees 10 each at rupees 20. So राइट शेयर कितना आएगा यहाँ पे? व्हाट इज द डेट ऑफ राइट शेयर? 12th November. द डेट गिवन इज 12th November. द कंपनी मेरा राइट इशू, सो 12th November दिया है. अगेन हमें राइट शेयर्स मिलेगा तो अवर शेयर होल्डिंग विल इंक्रीज, इन्वेस्टमेंट इंक्रीज हो जाएगा. तो यहाँ पे वी विल राइट टू कैश बैंक बिकॉज मनी विल गो आउट व्हेन वी विल परचेज राइट शेयर्स. 600 × 10 6000 एंड राइट शेयर्स आर परचेज फॉर हाउ मच 20 rupees 600 × 12 सो राइट शेयर्स हो गया. बट वन मोर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, यू हैव टू ऐड द राइट शेयर्स. सो विल राइट ऐड राइट शेयर्स, ऐड राइट शेयर्स. Here we are getting 600 right shares. This will become 6000 and we are getting for 12000. We are getting the right share for 20 rupees 600 × 12. This will become 5600. This will become 56000 and this will become 65500. Now they have given, after this date, there are, see here, Mr. Arvind renounced the remaining shares on receipt of premium of 3 per share. That we are not concerned. We are concerned with the number of shares Mr. Arvind has subscribed for. Usne khud ke liye kitna right shares rakha, hame usse important, hame usse concern hai. That is important for us. So that we have done the 20 December 2012 ko, that is the same. 20 December ko, how many shares we have sold? 1500 at 22 rupees. So let us do the entry of sale. So 2012 ko, what is the date? 20 December. So again ye yahan pe, let us keep one down and here 2012. So let us write 2012 for what happened. Sale has happened. So again we will get money when it is a sale. How many shares? 1500 × 10. So 15,000. How many shares? 1500 shares at 22 rupees. So sale at 22 rupees. So do 1500 × 22. How much you are getting? 1500 × 22. We are selling for 33,000. So whenever it is a sale, one more thing we will find out. Either this is working note number 3. Working note number 3, right share calculation. Now we have to go for profit or loss calculation. So fourth one. Calculation of profit or loss. So how much is the sales price? Sales price is how much? Sales price is 33,000 here. At how much price have we sold 1500 shares? 33,000. So we will write here 33,000. Now less weighted average cost. Weighted average cost. For that, let us come here. Less cost structure. Less sale. 1500. Let this become 15,000. Now let us do a cross multiplication. Cross multiplication karenge. So 15,000 × 65,500 divide by 56,000. How much are we getting? 15,000 × 65,500. Divide by 56,000. We are getting how much? We are getting 17. We are getting here 7. How much value we are getting? 17,000. 1 minute. 17,000. What is the value? 7 ही less करना है तो bracket में let us show 17,544.6. तो उसको 45 कर देंगे. So this we are getting. Correct, everyone are getting. Tell me, is it a profit or a loss? 17,545 का चीज हमने 33,000 में सेल किया. Means it is a profit. Let us calculate the amount of profit. 33,000 minus 17,545 means it's a profit of 15,455. Yes, 15,455. So correct. Are everyone getting the same answer? Cross multiplication. 15,000. Check whether you are getting the same answer. Divide by 56,000. Yes, we are getting the same answer. So let us write profit means where it will come. Profit means it will come in the debit side. So 2012 to profit and loss account, the last we will write 15. What is the amount? 15,455. So now what we will do, we will write here also what is the amount of the cost. It is 17,545 and minus karke kitna aayega? 56,000 minus 15,000 means यहाँ पे 4,100, यहाँ पे 41,000, यहाँ पे 65,500 माइनस 17,545, वी आर गेटिंग 47,955. नाउ वी गो टू द नेक्स्ट, दैट इज वन मोर सेल विच हैपेंड ऑन 1/2/2013, फर्स्ट फेब्रुवरी फॉर 24 रुपीज and 1,000 units. So 1/2, we pehle 2013 and we will write 1/2. So it is again by cash bank and how many 1,000 shares. So this will be 10,000, 1,000 into 10, and we have sold for 24 rupees. So this becomes 24,000. 24,000. So let us go and calculate the profit loss. Less sale, 1,000. Here it will come 10,000. We will do a cross multiplication. Fifth one, calculation of profit or loss. sales price is 24,000 less weighted average price. Cross multiplication 10,000 into 47955 divided by 41,000. So do a cross multiplication. 10,000 into 47955 divided by 41,000. We are getting 11,696. Again, cost is lesser than the sale proceeds. So again, this is a profit. How much profit we are getting? 24,000 minus 11,696. We are getting 12,304. So we'll go profit. Yahan pe working note 4 and 5. Again, profit hai. This is 2013 February. Again, same thing. Profit hai, P&L account. And how much is the amount of profit we got now? We got 12,304. Right here. 12,304. So all the profits are done. Now let us write here. What amount is the cost? 11,696. 11,696. So here it will be 3,100. Here it is 31,000. And here it is 47,955. 47,955 minus 11,696. It is 36,259. Let us see here, because the last entry is done. Now we can close it. So either what is the date? 31st March. 31st March ko buy balance carried down. So here let us close this. How much it is coming? Pehle close karte hai. 15,000 plus 10,000 plus 25,000 plus 6,000. We are getting 56,000. Here also 34,500 plus 22,000 plus 12,000 plus 15,455 plus 12,304. We are getting 96,259. So we will copy this here and let us see what amount we are getting. 1 minute. Yeah, there is a list here. यहाँ से हटा कर यहाँ पे लिखेंगे. डिविडेंड के कॉलम में लिख दिया गलती से. और दिस वन ऑल्सो, ये 10,000 हम इधर लिखना चाहिए. बाय मिस्टेक या वो देयर. तो बैलेंस में कितना आ रहा है? बैलेंस में कितना आ रहा है? लेट अस सी. 56,000 minus 15,000 minus 10,000. We are getting 31,000. And here, what we are getting? 3,000 plus 33,000 plus 24,000 minus 96,259. We are getting 36,259. Let me check whether this is tally. Yes, it is tally. So this both the amount are coming equal to the cost picture. So I'm highlighting this. Now we have to close one more column, that is dividend. So here 4,500. Here also it will come 4,500. But ye dividend kidhar jayega? On 31st March 2013, this will go to P&L account. This is income from investment. Income from investment. So ye middle column me, yahan se will show 4,500. Which is income from investment. With this sum is done. Thank you very much, everyone. I end the lecture here.